फॉरेन एक्सचेंज एंड कैपिटल बस्टिंग। समटाइम्स वी मेक ओवरसीज इन्वेस्टमेंट्स, समटाइम्स वी इनकर कैपिटल एक्सपेंडिचर इन अदर कंट्रीज, दैट इज आवर डिसीजन इन्वॉल्व्स फॉरेन एक्सचेंज। सो हाउ टू टेक कैपिटल एक्सपेंडिचर डिसीजंस व्हेन फॉरेन एक्सचेंज इज इन्वॉल्व्ड, इन दिस कनेक्शन टू अप्रोचेस आर देयर। वन इज होम करेंसी अप्रोच, इन दिस अप्रोच वी कन्वर्ट ऑल कैश फ्लोज इन होम करेंसी, द डिस्काउंट रेट शुड बी द रिक्वायर्ड रेट ऑफ रिटर्न इन होम करेंसी। फॉरेन करेंसी अप्रोच, नो नीड टू कन्वर्ट द कैश फ्लोज इन होम करेंसीज, मेक डीसीएफ एनालिसिस इन फॉरेन करेंसी, द डिस्काउंटिंग रेट शुड बी द रिक्वायर्ड रेट ऑफ रिटर्न इन फॉरेन करेंसी। दिस पॉइंट वी शैल बी डिस्कसिंग लेटर ऑन, हाउ टू फाइंड द डिस्काउंटिंग रेट इन फॉरेन करेंसी वी शैल डिस्कस लेटर ऑन। द एनपीवी कैलकुलेटेड इन फॉरेन करेंसी शुड बी कन्वर्टेड इन होम करेंसी एट द फॉरेन एक्सचेंज रेट इन द जीरो पीरियड। लेट्स रिवाइज इट। फॉरेन करेंसी अप्रोच, देयर इज नो नीड टू कन्वर्ट कैश फ्लोज इन होम करेंसी, मेक डीसीएफ एनालिसिस इन फॉरेन करेंसी, द डिस्काउंटिंग रेट शुड बी द रिक्वायर्ड रेट ऑफ रिटर्न इन फॉरेन करेंसी। दिस पॉइंट वी शैल डिस्कस इन डिटेल लेटर ऑन। द एनपीवी कैलकुलेटेड इन फॉरेन करेंसी शुड बी कन्वर्टेड इन होम करेंसी एट द फॉरेन एक्सचेंज रेट इन द इनिशियल पीरियड और जीरो पीरियड। एनपीवी वुड बी सेम अंडर बोथ द अप्रोचेस। If the question is silent on this point, the first approach is preferred. Question number 7.41. Please refer to the chapter Project Planning and Capital Busting in the textbook. Please go through the question thoroughly. An Indian firm is considering an investment in Switzerland. Investment is CHF 22 million. Spot rate CHF rupees 24. Life of the project is 5 years. Question clearly states that real interest rates are same. Hence, the given risk-free rates are nominal. We have two types of rates, real interest rates and nominal interest rates. Question says that real interest rates are same. The given interest rates, the rates given in the question are not same. The risk-free interest rates given in the question are not same. It means those rates are nominal. We shall be using those rates to find the forward rates of CHF. Home currency approach. Spot, 1 CHF is equal to rupees 24. 1 year forward rate. CHF is compound with CHF interest rate, that is 8%. Rupee is compounded with rupee interest rate. Question clearly states that real interest rates are same. It means the risk-free rates given in the question 8% in CHF and 12% in rupee are not real rates. These are nominal rates. We are calculating forward rates using interest rate parity theory. In interest rate parity theory, nominal rates are used. So 1 year forward rate, this is the spot rate. To find 1 year forward rate, CHF will be compounded with CHF interest rate, rupee will be compounded with rupee interest rate. So 1 CHF is equal to rupees 24.89. 2 year forward rate, the basis of calculation will be this rate, spot rate. This will be compounded twice. This will be compounded thrice with interest rates, 4 years, 5 years. Spot rate is 1 CHF is equal to rupees 24. 1 year forward CHF will be 24.89. 2 year forward CHF will be 25.81. 3 year forward CHF will be 26.77. 4 year forward CHF will be 27.76. And 5 year forward will be 28.79. So CHF is at premium. Home currency approach. We calculate net present value. Net present value will be minus 22 million CHF at the rate of rupees 24. You have to pay this much amount in rupees. In the zero period, you have to invest 22 million CHF, and 22 million CHF you can buy at 22 into 24, so many rupees. At the end of first year, you receive 4 million CHF. 1 CHF is equal to rupees 24.89. And this is the present value factor at the discounting rate. What is the required rate of return? 14%. Required rate of return in rupee is 14%. So friends, this is your investment, 22 million CHF. In zero period, you have to buy 22 million CHF. For that, you will pay 22 million into CHF. This will be your cash outflow in rupees in the zero period. 4 million CHF you receive at the end of first year. At that time, the rate is 1 CHF is equal to rupees 24.89. So you will receive so many rupees. This is the present value factor at 14%, as the required rate of return in home currency is 14%. Second year, you receive 5 million CHF. At that time, 1 CHF is equal to rupees 25.81. This is present value factor at 14% for second year, for third year, fourth year, fifth year. NPV is equal to rupees 47.86 million. under home currency approach, we have converted all the cash flows in home currency. In zero period, there is cash outflow of 22 million CHF. We receive 4 million CHF. We receive 5 million CHF. We receive 6 million CHF. We receive 8 million CHF. We receive 10 million CHF. We have converted all CHF cash flows to rupees cash flows. And we have discounted them at the required rate of return in the home currency. We get our NPV. The main point in foreign currency approach is how to calculate the required rate of return in foreign currency. Friends, if we invest 100 rupees in India in risk-free security, if we invest 100 rupees in India for risk-free return, we certainly get 112, because 12% is your risk-free return. You invest rupees 100 today, you get 112. But if we invest in business, we expect to get 14 rupees return, 14% return, that is extra 2% return. But for getting extra risk premium of rupees 2, we are taking the risk of 112. If we invest 100 rupees in risk free, we will certainly get 112. If we invest 100 rupees in business, we may get even 0. It may be even 0. So, when we are taking risk of 112, our risk premium is 2. For risk of 1, our risk premium is 2 upon 112. For risk premium of 108, the risk premium is 2 divided by 112 into 108, that is 0.0192857, that is 1.92857%. If we invest 100 rupees in India in risk-free, we certainly get 112. If we invest in the business, we hope to get 114, but it may be even 0. So we are taking risk of 112 when we are investing in the business. And against that 112 risk, we have risk premium of 2. So for risk of 1, risk premium is this, business is the same. If you are investing 100 in risk-free in Switzerland, you are sure to get 108. And if you are investing in the business, it may be even 0. So in Switzerland, you are taking risk of 108. So risk premium should be 1.92857%. So required rate of return in CHF is equal to, this is the risk-free, this is the risk premium, required rate of return is 9.92857%. So under foreign currency approach, we shall discount all the cash flows at this rate. 22 million outflow in zero period. Inflow in the first year, discounted at the discounting rate of CHF. Second year, discounted at the discounting rate of or required rate of return of CHF. Similarly, for the fifth year, this will be the NPV in foreign currency. I have multiplied with foreign currency rate in the zero period. This will give me NPV in rupees. Question number 7.42. Please refer to the chapter Project Planning and Capital Budgeting in the textbook. A UK firm is investing in USA. We are not given the required rate of return in dollar. We cannot find the required rate of return in dollar. Hence, we can attempt the question only by home currency approach. We shall be converting all the cash flows in sterling pound and discount at the UK firm's required rate of return in sterling pound. Spot rate, £1 is equal to $2. This is the interest rate of pound. This is the interest rate of dollar. Pound interest rate is 8%. Dollar interest rate is 6%. So we can find 1 year forward rate. We can find 2 year forward rate, 3 year forward rate, 4 year forward rate, and 5 year forward rate. We are given the cash flows in dollar. We have to convert the cash flows into pound at different points of time. So we require different forward rates. This is the spot rate. This is the forward rate for 1 year. Pound interest rate is 8%. US interest rate is 6%. So this is compounding with interest rate of pound. Dollar is compound with interest rate of dollar for 1 year, for 2 year, for 3 year, for 4 year, for 5 year. This gives us forward rates for different years under interest rate parity theory. Annual profit before depreciation given in the question. Depreciation on straight line basis, tax. So annual cash flow will be this profit minus tax. Annual profit before depreciation, before tax. Out of this, if we deduct tax, we shall get our annual cash flow. Home currency approach. In the zero period, our investment will be 0.50 million pound. In the question, we are given the investment of $1 million. $1 million is equal to pound 0.50 million in the beginning of the project. At the end of first year, we will receive 0.444 million dollar. At that time, this is the forward rate of pound. So, $0.444 million converted into pound will result in receipt of so many pounds discounted at the rate of 10%. Second year, we shall receive $0.44 million converted at the second year's rate. Similarly, third year, fourth year, fifth year. In the fifth year, the working capital of $0.600 million will be recovered. This working capital of $0.600 million converted into pounds discounted at the discounting rate. Our NPV is pound 0.5917 million. The project may be taken up as the NPV is positive. Question number 7.43. Please refer to the chapter Project Planning and Capital Busting in the textbook. Please go through the question. An Indian firm is investing in Tanzania. The required rate of return is given in home currency. Hence, home currency approach is to be followed. Spot rate, 1 rupee is equal to 20 Tanzanian shilling. So this is 1 rupee compounded with rupee interest rate, compounded with Tanzanian shilling interest rate. Even after 1 year, the rate will remain unchanged. Second year, this rate will continue to be 8%, but this rate will be 9%. Third year, this rate will continue to be 8%. This rate will be 10%. We calculate forward rate for year 1, forward rate for year 2, and forward rate for year 3. In A part of the question, the joint venture shall be paying dividend equal to 100% of cash flow. First year, cash flow of the joint venture is 1 million Tanzanian shilling. Total dividend shall be 1 million Tanzanian shilling. Indian firm share shall be 0.50 million Tanzanian shilling. That is, at the end of first year, the Indian firm will receive 0.50 million Tanzanian shilling. At the end of second year, it will receive 0.75 million Tanzanian shilling. At the end of third year, it will receive 1 million Tanzanian shilling. This is the joint venture's cash flow. This is the amount of dividend. Amount of dividend is 100% of cash flow as given in the question. The Indian firm will receive 50% of this. In B part of the question, the annual dividend is 50% of cash flow. The balance of cash shall be shared by the two venturers in the beginning of the fourth year. So, in the first year, the joint venture will receive this much cash flow. Dividend will be 50% of this. Indian firm will receive its share of 0.25 million Tanzanian shilling. Second year end, it will receive this much. Third year end, this is the total cash flow of joint venture. It will pay 1 million Tanzanian shilling as dividend. Indian firm will receive its share. In the beginning of the fourth year, the joint venture will distribute the remaining amount of cash. Remaining amount of cash in the hands of joint venture is 2.25 million Tanzanian shilling. This will be distributed as dividend. Indian firm will receive 1.125 million Tanzanian shilling. NPV in first case. This is the investment in Tanzanian shilling divided by 20. This is the investment in rupees. This is the dividend divided by 20. This is the discounting rate at 10%. Dividend, foreign exchange rate, discounting rate. Dividend, foreign exchange rate, discounting rate. So our NPV is rupees 39,951. Second alternative, where the joint venture distributes 50% of cash flow as dividend and balance in cash is distributed in the beginning of fourth year. The Indian firm invests 1 million Tanzanian shilling in joint venture. For that, this is the cash outflow in rupees. 1 million Tanzanian shilling purchase at the rate of 1 rupee is equal to 20 Tanzanian shilling. So in initial period, our investment is this. First year, we will receive 0.250 million Tanzanian shilling as dividend converted into rupees at the rate of 20, discounted at 10%, which is the discounting rate for Indian company. In the end of second year, at the end of third year, in the beginning of fourth year, our NPV is 36,068.